Hello and welcome to Craft with Sarah. In this video, I'm going to walk through how to download the free SVGs and design space projects from my website. So to start, go to www.craftwithsarah.com. And then if you scroll down the homepage, you can see all of my most recent Cricut projects. And you can click into those to read the step-by-step instructions for each one. And most of these include a link to a free file. So if you just read through, you'll be able to see links to the free file that links to that particular blog post. So for this one on button art, I'm going to click the link to Flamingo button art. It'll open a new page where I can get that template. If you want to see all of my free SVGs and free design space projects in one go, instead of looking at a blog post first, just click freebies in the top navigation. This loads all of my craft freebies, and to limit it to just the Cricut ones, go over to the left and click the little box next to where it says free SVGs for Cricut. And that will filter all the results to just see the ones that you can open on your Cricut machine. To download a file, all you need to do is click into it. And you'll notice that all of these files are free. Click Add to Basket, and that will add it to your basket. You can add as many files as you want to your basket and then proceed to checkout. Again, don't worry, it's all completely free. You don't need to pay for any of my downloads. On the checkout page, if you've already got an account on my website, you can click here to log in. But if you don't, then fill out the boxes to register a free account. To make sure you never miss a new free SVG file or project, tick the box that says Get New Freebies emailed to you weekly. But if you'd prefer not to get newsletters from me, then you can just untick that box. Don't worry, you can still get access to all of your free downloads, even if you don't decide to subscribe to my newsletter. When you've entered all your details, click Place Order. Once that goes through, you'll see this screen, which lists out all of the different files that you've just chosen to download. Click on the orange button to start the download, and that file will just download to your computer, to wherever it is the internet files download. So if you're on a Windows PC, it will probably be your downloads folder. There are two types of Cricut project that I share on my blog. One are design space projects, which you can open directly in design space, and these usually use Cricut Access images in them. And the other are SVGs, which you have to upload manually into design space. There are a couple of things to keep in mind when using each of those different types of freebie. So keep watching for instructions on how to open both of those in design space and the things you need to do before you can cut. If you download one of my design space projects from my website, you'll get a PDF download which looks something like this. The link you want to open the project in design space is the one that starts with design.cricut.com. When you click on that link, it's going to open your internet browser and connect to Cricut. So it's going to ask you if you want to open the Cricut Design Space program. If you already have it on your computer, you can just click Open. If you don't have it, then you'll need to download it and install it. If you're not sure how to do that, check out my other videos for instructions on how to download and install Design Space on Windows, Mac, iPhone, and Android devices. Alright, so I do already have Design Space, so I'm just going to click Open. You'll probably get another pop-up asking if you want to open Design Space, so yes we do, click Open. And that's going to go ahead and open the Design Space program on the computer. It can be a bit slow to load, so bear with it and it'll get there eventually. Once it loads the project, you have two options down the bottom. You can either customize or make it. If you click Make It, it's going to go straight to the screen where you see all the different Cricut mats and you choose your material and cut it. If you want to customize the design, so change the size maybe, or the colors, or add anything else to it, click the Customize button instead. That'll load a canvas for you with everything from the project included, so then you can make your own changes to it before you click the Make It button. My favourite part about sharing design space projects is that all of the different tools that you might be using as part of this project can be done straight for you. So all you need to do is open the project and any score lines are already set to score and attached to the bit of card that they do need to score. So with this Dolphins card, which is a Cricut Design Space product, all you need to do is open up the project and then you can just click Make It. You don't need to change anything else. However, if you're using one of my projects from my blog, which is an SVG file that you need to upload into Cricut, rather than a pre-made Design Space project, there are a few extra steps you need to do before you can cut the files on your Cricut machine if there's any parts of the design which need to be changed to score lines. That's because when uploading a SVG file, Design Space doesn't have a way of recognising what lines should be score and what lines should be cut. So we just need to go in and tell it. Luckily, that's a really easy and straightforward process and it only takes about a minute. So I'm just going to skip to a new screen and import an SVG file to show you what I mean. Here's a card making project that I've downloaded from my blog. When it downloads, it comes in a zip folder, so you need to unzip it before you can load it into Design Space. To do that on a Windows PC, all you need to do is right click on the folder and then press Extract All, and then extract. That's made a new folder here, and if I double click into it, you can see I've got the SVG file here. Yours might not have a PS above it, it might show your internet browser icon or something different. It doesn't matter what the picture is, all that's showing you is the program you've got set up on your computer by default to open SVG files. So ignore the picture or the icon that's showing. All we're bothered about is that we can see this file in the folder we've just extracted. Open up Design Space and then click New Project in the top left. Down the left hand side there's a button which says Upload. Click that and then click into Upload Image. Find the SVG file and then you can add it into Design Space either by clicking the Browse button or click and drag and drop. Make sure you drag and drop the file name that ends in .svg, not the picture of the finished card or project. Okay, so once that's loaded in there, press Save, and it'll import the SVG to your recently uploaded images, where you can just click it, and then click Insert Images. This has put the SVG file onto our canvas. And you can see already that this is a little bit different to how the Dolphin card looked because there's nothing here which says score line. There's one cut line which is the very top layer usually when I'm making SVGs, and if we hide everything else we can see that this cut line is just a single line down the canvas, and that's the one we need to change to a score line. So click on the layer in the layers panel and then go to the top of the screen where it says line type and change that to score. That's changed the line so it's now all dashed, which indicates it's a score line. So now we can turn everything back on and you might think that now it's ready to make it, but if I go and click make it now you can see we're not quite there, because what Cricut's going to do is it's going to score that line all on its own on a map. And it's not going to actually put it as part of the card. So I'm going to cancel out of this. I'm going to show you how to attach that score line to the main card. The first thing you need to do is ungroup everything. So click on your group name at the top, which is the very first line you have in your layers panel. Right click on that and then press ungroup. This has ungrouped our layers, so we've now got them separate. But it's kept that score line and cut line grouped together. So all we need to do is to select that group by pressing the top line, and you can see the score and the cut are both grey, which means they're selected. Go down to the bottom and press attach. Now my score line is attached to my main card, so if I click make it now, they're part of the same mat, so they're going to happen on the same bit of card. You'll notice at the top I've got a message telling me that my images are too big, so it's not going to cut at the moment, so I need to make everything smaller. To do that, select all layers and then group them. And then you can either use the arrow icon in the bottom right to change the size, or what's easiest, if you know what size card you want to make, is just to go to the top and change the width and the height in here. So if I put 7 inches tall, it's going to change the width for me in proportion. So now when I click make it, everything is correctly sized, the score line is attached to the card, and it's ready for me to cut. So this ended up being a little bit of a long video, but don't worry, because as soon as you've done this once or twice on different SVG files, you'll just start learning how to do it and it'll all be automatic. So when you upload an SVG file, you'll be able to get those score lines converted and attached to your main card in probably about a minute, so it's not going to take you any time at all once you get used to doing it. So I hope this video has helped you to understand the difference between downloading a design space project link from my blog and an SVG file. To get all of my free Cricut files, head on over to www.craftwithsarah.com or follow the link in the description underneath the video here. I upload new files every week, as well as new Cricut tutorials and design space tutorials. Check out what I've got on there and don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching. Bye.